Okay, I am giving one question to you, beta, and the question is arrange. Elements of second and third period in increasing order of their atomic size. Okay. This is the your question. You have to first.
So I take it like
yes, you are saying something, but please.
So I take like the elements of the second period, like fluorine and oxygen, and in the increasing order.
Yes.
Okay.
Firstly, you have to take second period, then third period. For both, you have to write.
Okay. So, do I write it on the screen or in my notebook?
Whatever you can.
Okay, so there's a fluorine in on. So there's fluorine, and then it's oxygen, nitrogen, then there is carbon, boron, and then boron and beryllium, neon, and lithium.
No, actually, you're wrong because neon has the greatest size. If you know, the inner gases are having the greatest size. So neon is placed like here. And you have to put like this. Neon has the greatest size, so neon is here only.
Okay, sir.
Got it?
Okay. Yes, I understood.
For third period, you write.
Third period, it's first is chlorine, then sulfur, phosphate, silicone, then silicone, and then aluminium, magnesium, argon, and sodium.
No, argon is on here only because argon is an inert.
Okay.
So please learn this concept, beta. All the inert gases are having highest in size, or they are greater.
Okay.
You have to write this concept. I think you forget this. No problem.
Yes.
Second is, which is greater in size. Option one, an atom or a cation. Number B, an atom or anion. Number C, Fe2+, Fe3+.
So it'll be Fe2+, Fe3+.
Yes.
Because the atom is so for the first one.
No.
It'll be an atom.
My question is, which is greater in size, an atom or a cation?
So an atom is bigger than the cation, because the cations are formed due to the loss of the electrons.
Okay.
And the protons are more than electrons in the cation.
Yes. So the force of attraction increases, the size decreases.
Yes. Electrons are attracted to the nucleus, so they're pulled like towards it.
Yes, yes. In this one, B part.
So an anion, because the anion is formed because they gain electrons.
Okay. And C one.
Electron. For Fe2 plus will be greater than Fe3 plus.
Okay.
Because the last outermost shell is forms the Fe3 plus ion. So when the electrons are removed, it reduces the attraction, and it increases the charge of the nuclear charge.
Okay.
And it decreases the ion.
Okay, no problem. Good. So today, I think, beta, we have to discuss. We discussed the atomic ionization energy. I think in the last class. Last class we discussed about the ionization energy. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You made in notes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Now today we are going to discuss electron gain energy. Electron gain energy. So what is the electron gain energy, beta? One second. The amount of energy which is obtained when any element gains one electron. Because, beta, this is the exothermic process. So amount of energy is released always. Okay. That means, beta, when X element gains an electron, it gains an electron and makes it anion, and lot of amount of energy is released. Next is, what is the trend on moving left to right? On moving left to right, like, you know, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, always the electron gain energy increases because electron gaining nature increases. But if we move up to down, like lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, and cesium, beta, electron gain energy decreases.
Yes.
Okay. Is any problem?
No, sir. No problem.
Okay. You can write, if you want to note, you can.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, my main question is, beta, you have two elements. One is sodium and one is fluorine, or we can say chlorine. So, which is having more electron gain enthalpy?
So sodium has more.
Why?
Because when you go down, down the period, it the electrons gain energy.
Please concentrate once again, beta. Sodium and chlorine both are resided in the same period.
Okay.
And right side chlorine. So when we move left to right, electron gain energy increases.
Okay.
Got it? So which is having more electron gain energy?
It'll be
chlorine.
Chlorine, yes.
Okay, got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Why is this? Because beta, you discuss all the metals are ready to gain electron. All the non-metals are ready to gain electron, and all the metals are ready to lose electron. Because chlorine is non-metal, so it easily accept electron. Whenever it easily accept electron, the more amount of energy is released. Okay?
Okay.
So, it generally depend upon the non-metallic nature. If you want to write it, this is a key point for this.
Okay.
Next is, beta, if you talk about the inert gases.
Yes.
So inert gases in do not accept electron, or they do not want to accept electron. Because, beta, they are already have completed octet. So they're
stable.
Gain energy as endothermic because they are stable. So they are stable, beta. That means, beta, they do not want to gain electron at any case. By hook or crook, we have to just enter the electron into that particular atom. Okay. So they are having the most minimum electron gain energy. You have to write it. They are having most minimum electron gain energy.
Okay.
Okay, got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, beta, another trend we have to discuss. Another trend is, one second.
Yes.
One second. Only one second. Please wait. Can you see this periodic table, beta, easily?
It's loading, just one second. Yes, sir, I can.
Okay. So now, beta, we come to understand metallic and non-metallic nature. Or you can take a screenshot whenever I complete the task, okay?
Okay.
Whenever we metallic and non-metallic nature. So Varuska, can you tell me what is exactly the metals? Can you define what is metals?
So metals, they give out the electrons.
Very good.
And non-metals, they accept electrons.
Okay. So metals are basically those elements which donate their electron, and non-metals are basically those accept electron. So as you know that, beta, when you come left to right across the period like this way, metallic nature decreases. Metallic nature decreases. And when we come to up to down, metallic nature increases. So if you talk about lithium, sodium, potassium, so can you tell me which of the following is the best metal or good metal, we can say?
So it's lithium.
No, beta, I am saying that my question is, among lithium, sodium and potassium, which is the good metal? Because beta, as we move left to right, as we move up to down, the metallic nature RBs increased.
Oh, it increases.
Increases. So among Li, potassium and sodium,
so it's potassium.
It is the having highest metallic properties.
Okay.
Like, beta, in the same way, if we move diagonally means like this way.
Yes.
Metallic nature increases.
Okay.
So basically, metallic nature means losing of electron. If you say metallic nature, that means we are talking about the losing of electron nature. Okay, so if you see, beta, like polonium, PO, bismuth, lead, these are all metals. Okay, tin and germanium, they are metalloid, beta.
Yes.
Okay. And arsenic is sometimes metalloid or amphoteric. Amphoteric means, what is amphoteric?
It's like
Ampho means both. Like ampho means both, beta. Ampho keyword basically represent both. That means, beta, it tells about the metallic nature as well as the non-metallic nature. Okay. Arsenic is arsenic and antimony both are having the amphoteric type of material. Okay. Boron is a typical non-metal. It is a typical non-metal. You can write if you want, or you can snapshot. It's a typical non-metal.
Okay.
Then, beta, if you talk about these elements, these are S block element, these are P block element, very well. These middle element are D block element, and these are F block element. So one thing is very clear, one thing is very fascinating, beta. Representative elements, sometimes they can ask. Representative element. S block and P block element are known as representative element. representing elements are S block element and P block element. Okay, beta?
Okay.
Got it? All the point, all the keywords here?
Yes, sir.
If I am revising again, beta, if we move left to right, metallic nature decreases. If we move up to down, metallic nature increases. If we move diagonally, left to right, metallic nature increases. Okay. Representing elements are S block P element and P block element. And these middle element are known as transition element, as you know.
Yes.
If you are having any doubt, you can ask me, beta.
No, sir, no doubt.
You took snapshot?
Yes, sir.
Now, you know, if you talk about the chemical reactivity, so if you talk about the chemical reactivities for metal basically gain electron. As soon as any metal gains electron, it becomes chemically reactive or as well as any non-metal. Okay. I think I made wrong statement. As soon as any non-metal gain electron, it becomes chemically reactive, or as soon as any metal lose electron, it becomes reactive. So we can say that more metallic nature, more reactive, and more non-metallic nature, more reactive. Is any doubt?
No, sir, no doubts.
Everything is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So should I change the slide?
Yes, sir. I did a screenshot.
Okay. I have one question. The question is, state the trend in chemical reactivity number 1 across the period, and number 2 down to the group. Please state, beta, what is your appropriate answer?
So when it's left to right, like across the period, it increases, the reactivity increases, and for the group it decreases. So it's like across the period the chemical
reactivity no problem.
Of the decreases
no,
and then
no problem. I am writing the keyword like lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. Now you can give answer. Now you give answer.
Yes. Like when the reactivity increases when you go left to right across the period, I'm not sure how to frame the answer.
But first see the elements nature. You know, lithium is a metal, beryllium is a metal, boron is a non-metal, carbon is a non-metal, nitrogen is a non-metal, oxygen is a non-metal, fluorine is a non-metal. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
You know that when metallic nature is more, reactivity is more, and when non-metallic nature is more, obviously the reactivity is more. Is there any doubt here?
No, sir, no doubts.
So when we move left to right here, metallic nature decreases. So reactivity decreases. First, as we move left to right, metallic nature decreases, hence chemical reactivity decreases. Then non-metallic nature increases, hence reactivity increases. Okay?
Yes.
Got it?
Yes.
If you just see another, like sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, chlorine, and other like argon. So no need to argon here. So sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, and chlorine. As you know, metallic nature first decreases, then non-metal increases. So as metallic nature decreases, chemical reactivity decreases. As non-metallic nature increases, chemical reactivity increases. Okay?
Okay.
Any doubt?
No, sir. No doubt.
So what is your answer down to the group?
So when it's down the group, the metallic nature increases,
mm-hmm.
and the chemical reactivity also increases.
Very good.
So the non-metallic nature decreases, and the reactivity decreases.
Firstly, beta, if you talk about the metals. As you know, metallic nature increases, reactivity increases. If you talk about the non-metals, reactivity decreases because non-metallic nature decreases.
So can you repeat the question?
Okay, because beta, we have two types of actually like sodium, this is for metal.
Yes, sir.
As we move left to right, up to down, metallic nature increases. Chemical reactivity increases. In the same way?
Yes.
Okay. Both metals and non-metals, there are two different kind of behaviors we can say.
Okay.
Is any doubt, beta?
No, sir, no doubt.
Can I rough it?
Yes, sir.
So, Varuska, beta, what is the name of group 60, the group 17 element, you know? These are halogens.
Yes, sir.
And its valence minus or one, we can say. Group 16.
Yes.
Assembly.
Yes, sir.
They are chalcogens. Their valences are minus two. And group 15 is pentogens.
Yes.
Their valences is minus three. Their group 13 common valency is three. Group 14 common valency is four. Group two is known as, you know, alkaline earth metal.
Yes, sir.
And it's having valency plus two. And group first are alkali metal, its valency is plus one. And all those elements which are resided in the D block, they are having variable valencies.
Yes.
Like if you know iron has two valencies, Fe2 plus and Fe3 plus. Copper, you can say copper 2 plus and copper 1 plus. Okay, beta?
Yes, sir.
Is any doubt here?
No, sir, no doubt.
You want to note, you want to take a shot?
Yes. Okay.
Done?
Yes, sir, I took a screenshot.
You know. But a water amphoteric element, those element which shows the nature of both metallic and non-metal. Okay, are known as amphoteric. So how many amphoteric element, you know, we have one venomonic, sub, gen, ki, as, suno, prabhu, allah. Okay, sub, gen, ki, as, prabhu, allah. So sub is antimony. मतलब जिंक, की साइलेंट, आस मतलब आर्सेनिक, सुनो मतलब टिन, टीबी मतलब लेड एंड अल्लाह मतलब एयर. दैट मींस बेटा दोज मेटल्स आर दोज काइंड ऑफ मेटल्स व्हिच कैन रिप्रेजेंट द मेटालिक नेचर एज वेल एज द नॉन मेटालिक नेचर. सो दे आर नोन एज एम्फोटेरिक एलिमेंट्स.
ओके,
गॉट इट?
यस सर.
And you know what are metalloid? Metalloid are something different. Metalloid are some different, you know. So germanium and silicon, two elements are metalloids.
Yes.
These elements form amphoteric oxide as well. These elements form amphoteric oxide. Like, if you talk about Al2O3, amphoteric oxide are those oxide, beta, which react acid as well as with bases. If you can write, you can note it. Amphoteric oxide are those oxide which react with acid as well as with bases.
Okay, sir.
Would I rough it?
Yes, sir.
One second, beta. I'm coming.
Yes.
Yes, beta, you are smiling.
No, sir, I'm not smiling. So for the first one, it'll be fluorine, oxygen, fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, boron, beryllium, and lithium, and
okay.
Then neon. There's no neon. And then it'll be chlorine, sulfur, phosphate, phosphorus, aluminium, magnesium, and then sodium.
But our question is in decreasing order of non-metallic. So firstly, we have to write non-metal, then metal.
Okay.
Firstly, we have to write non-metal. So which is having the highest non-metallic nature? Chlorine. And till sodium. Isn't it?
Yes.
Is any doubt?
No, sir, no doubt.
Okay. You are noting these questions or not?
Yes, sir, I am. The answers.
A metal M forms an oxide. Having formula M2O3. It belongs to third period write the atomic number and valency of the metal. In element of a, or we can say in metals having oxide having formula M2O3. It is having formula M2O3. It belongs to third period. Write the atomic number and their valencies, and its valencies, sorry.
Yes, sir. So,
so beta, the clue is if it belongs to third period, so definitely it is having three cells, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
First is 2, second is 8, because it is having valency 3, because you know M2O3, the valency of M is 3 and the valency of O is 2, you know, cross multiplication we have to do.
Yes, sir.
So it is 283 because its valency is 3 and 283's atomic number is 13 and 13 atomic.
So the valence shell has 3 electrons?
Yes, yes. The valence shell has 3 electrons. So
it's aluminium?
Yes, so it's aluminium answer.
Okay.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
Should I rough it?
Yes, sir.
Next question. The element form the 17 group has 7 electrons. In the one second. Do you have any class back to back?
No, sir, it's fine.
The question is, I am repeating the question, an element X belongs to third period and 17 group of the state. 17 group and third periods it belong. Number of valence electron in it, beta?
So if the element belongs to the 17th group, so the valence seven, the valence electrons are 7.
Very good. Name of the
and halogens.
Yes, very good.
Sorry, and the
element is chlorine.
Chlorine, yes, sir.
Because and, 2, 8, 7.
Yes.
Write the formula of the compound when it reacts with 13 Y. It is 13 Y 7 27.
So okay, so So it's like we so it's the 20, I'm not sure which one it is. The atomic number is 27.
No, atomic mass is 27, but atomic number is 13.
Oh, okay. Sorry. So, so I'm not sure. I forgot the
No, no problem, Beta. You have to take the formula making concept. You have to take the formula making concept. So its electronic configuration is, you know, 2, 8, 3, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Oh, so it's aluminium.
Valency is 3. Valency of chlorine is 1. You have to toss multiply. Formula will become Y1Cl3. Okay.
Yes.
Any doubt?
It's aluminium chloride.
Yes, aluminium chloride. Okay. You can write aluminium chloride.
So, CL3.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So for concept part, Beta, we discussed the concept part. One concept is only remained for this chapter.
Yes, sir.
So, till Beta, is any doubt?
No, sir, no doubts.
You got all the things?
Yes, sir, I understood.
Okay. Now, Beta, one concept we have remained only, that is all the metallic oxide are basic by nature. And all the non-metallic oxide acidic by nature. Basic oxide means, Beta, if you know Na2O, basic means metallic oxide, CaO,
yeah.
MgO. Okay, if you want to check it, then just add them into water.
Okay.
And you got NaOH, CaOH whole twice, MgOH whole twice. So all of these basic. And all the non-metallic oxide are acidic, like CO2, NO2, SO2. These are all acidic, like H2CO3, HNO3. H2SO4, because, Beta, they all make acids. They all make bases, so they are acidic. Okay?
Yes.
Some of the oxide are neutral. You have to write these oxide. Like NO, CO, and N2.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
So please note, Peter.
Yes.
Yes, beta.
So one minute, almost done writing. Okay, so I finished.
Okay. So then beta, we did all the chapters concept. So what you have to do exercise of this chapter by the Dalal book, which you have, I think. Okay. Start doing the exercise beta. Anyway, I will send another assignment to you. And please complete the assignment which I given. Yes. Please complete the assignment. Please start doing the assignment of chapter one of your school book. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So we'll meet you, I think, in Tuesday. Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Welcome, beta. Welcome.